Hello folks, welcome back. In this video I am going to show you how to install Ansible on RHEL 8. Ansible installation procedure has been changed a little bit than before, so you just need to follow the steps carefully to install it. Necessary information is updated in our GitHub repository under Velaxy Tech account. Let's jump in and have a look what steps we should follow. I am in my GitHub repository. Here we have a directory called Ansible. Under Ansible, Ansible installation on RHEL 8. Prerequisites to follow this document is we should have an RHEL EC2 instance. Once you have provisioned your RHEL EC2 instance, first you should install Python. In RHEL 8, if you want to install Python 2, then you should specify it as a Python 2, otherwise Python 3. So we are installing Python 3. For that, yum install Python 3-y. Once you have installed, if you try to execute just Python, it doesn't work. So you should set up alternatives as a Python for your Python 3 command. Once you have set up alternatives, you can check for Python version. Then we should install Python 3 pip as well. Mostly Python pip comes with Python, so you may need not to install pip again. If it is not there, install it, because it allows us to install Ansible. Next step is, we are not going to install Ansible as a root user. It doesn't allow in RHEL 8. For that purpose, we should create a separate user. In this case, I am creating a user called ANSAdmin and set up the password for ANSAdmin. Then add ANSAdmin user to sudoers file for sudo access. Next, we need to enable password based authentication and reload SSHD so that it can take effect. Once it is done, switch as the ANSAdmin. This is the important step. If you try to install Ansible as a root admin, it doesn't work as expected. So once you have switched as a ANSAdmin, pip 3 install Ansible --user. Nothing but as a ANSAdmin user, you can install this Ansible. Then check for your version and generate keys and copy the ID onto target system. Once it is done, you can do the validation steps by adding a directory called /etc/ansible. This is one more change. By default, you don't get /etc/ansible in our latest version of Ansible 2.8. So you should create this folder and hosts file to add your hosts, or else you can create your own hosts file in your home directory to use it. Once that is done, you can do the testing. All right. Let's jump into our AWS console. Select EC2. Launch an instance. We are going to choose RHEL 8. Select it. T2 micro. Nothing to change here. Nothing to change here too. Add tag. Name RHEL 8 server. Security group, I am choosing existing security group, that is DevOps SG. Key pair also I am choosing DevOps. Launch instance. It takes a while, we'll wait until it comes up. Our server is in running state right now. Let's take public IP. I'm using tool called MobiExtern. Let me open MobiExtern. Session, SSH, public IP. Choose private key. It is DevOps key. Username, EC2-user. OK to connect. I'm able to log in. Let me increase the font size. Become a root. Because we are installing Python and Ansible, so we should have root privileges. First, let's check for Python. Python is not installed. Let's install Python. Yum install Python 3. In RHEL 8, you need to provide either you need Python 2 or Python 3. We need latest version of Python, so Python 3 it is. Installation is successful. Now again we'll execute Python version command. Still you cannot see, because you should execute Python 3 -version. If you want to use just Python command, then you need to create alternatives for this. It is there in our document. Let's take this command and execute it. This time we are going to execute Python minus minus version and it should work. See here, it's working. Next thing is we need to install pip. Whenever we install Python, it automatically installs pip as well. Let's try it just to cross check. Yes, it's available. Once it is done, we should create ANS admin user. Let me clear the screen. User add ANS admin and set up the password. I have set the password. Then we should add this user to sudoers file. Shift G and O. Username is ANS admin and followed by same privileges whatever EC2 minus user has. Right. Now we should enable password based authentication. For that, etc ssh sshd underscore config and enter. So search for password and go to end of this line and change it to password authentication to s. Once it is done, reload sshd. Okay, everything is set. Now we want to install Ansible. So far we haven't installed. In RHEL 8, we should install Ansible as a ANS admin user or a Ansible user, whatever we create. We cannot install with root user. It doesn't work as expected. So let's switch to ANS admin in our case. To install, we should use a command called pip3 because we have installed Python 3. pip3 install Ansible minus minus user, nothing but take ANS admin as a user. Now Ansible installation is completed. Let's check for version. We have installed 2.8 and config file none. Usually in older versions you can see config file as /etc/ansible/ansible.cfg, but in the latest versions you cannot see that one. But we need host file to execute our playbooks. So we are going to create /etc/ansible directory. Under that, I create a file called hosts to keep our hosts file. So let's create it. And we should do it with sudo because I'm a ANS admin user. Ansible directory is created. Go inside to Ansible directory. And create a file called hosts, sudo vi. Hosts, and we don't have any client systems right now, so I'm using my Ansible server itself as a client. Just I will add entry as localhost. So I'm using this system itself as a client for my Ansible control server. Next, we need to create SSH keys to enable passwordless authentication between your Ansible control system to managed hosts. Let's generate it. SSH key gen. Now we should copy it onto target systems. As I said, we don't have any target systems. We have added only local host. Let me copy into this system itself, because even though it is a local, you should copy your keys, or you can use the local connection, or else you can use connection as local, but it would be confusing. Let me copy the key pair. SSH copy ID local host. Yes, first time you need to provide password. I have entered password again. Oops. Okay, I have given right password this time. Number of keys added one. Successfully we have added. Now let's test our connection. Ansible all minus m ping. Okay, I could able to ping to our system without any issues. This is how you can set up Ansible on your RHEL server. Hope this video helps you, and see you in the next video.